Welcome to this talk about neural citation recommendation, a reproducibility study. My name is Michael Ferber, and together with Timo Klein and Johann Siegloch, we are from the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology in Germany. I brought with me today here a small cartoon, as you can see, and it illustrates quite well that writing text is obviously not so easy. It's actually quite difficult to not only write the text, but also to cite the corresponding papers in the case of academia. This is the case especially because there are a lot of papers which you might need to know, which you might need to read, and which you might need to cite, therefore. So here you can see the number of publications indexed in the Computer Science Bibliography DBLP. You can see that over the years, the number of in-proceedings, books, and articles has increased steadily, not to say exponentially. So it becomes more and more an issue to know all the papers which you should read, which you should cite, and so on. So here is where citation recommendation comes into play. The problem is that you have a lot of papers which you could use for citation. And the solution is to have some kind of guidance. So in the case of citation recommendation, you get a ranked list of publications which might be suitable for citing in a specific context. We can differentiate between global citation recommendation and local citation recommendation. Global citation recommendation refers to the task that you have, for example, a text document like a scientific publication, and you want to know which references are suitable for these texts. So basically, you want to re-predict the reference section, you can say. In the case of local citation recommendation, as the name suggests, it's for a specific context. This can be, for example, one sentence or up to three sentences, also often in a scientific publication. And you want to back up specific concepts or statements, claims, and so on. This is where we want to focus on in the future. Here, however, first of all citation recommendation approaches which have already been published, so you might wonder that there are so many. The first approaches have already been published around 2002 and then in the upcoming years. In blue are the approaches which provide local citation recommendation approaches. An overview over these approaches are given in the Citation Recommendation Approaches and Datasets survey, which I have published on archive. Here's an overview over local citation recommendation, because we want to focus on them now. And we can see that the approaches still differ in several regards, not only in the underlying approach, but also, for example, in the citation contact length. As I said, it can be one sentence, three sentences, and so on. This heavily depends on the use evaluation dataset. And then it can be that a few approaches might need the content of the cited papers, so the content of the papers which could be cited. But this is often not so useful because authors might want to cite any paper. And so we limited ourselves to papers which do not need this cited papers content. So we end up with the approaches of Tang, Huang, Ying, and Ebesu. And finally, we decided to go for Ebesu and Fang because it's one of the most recent approaches from 2017. It's often cited and it does not need the cited papers content. The paper's title is Neural Citation Network for Context-Aware Citation Recommendation. The neural network architecture is displayed here, so I will also go into more detail in the following now. Basically, it consists of an encoder-decoder network with an attention layer, and it particularly contains also an author network, so you do not only provide the citation context, but also the citing author and the potential cited author. What contributions do we have now? Well, we first re-implemented this neural citation network because this was not really runnable. It was provided on GitHub, but quite old code, even with the old Python version, it was not really executable. So we re-implemented this from scratch. Secondly, then, we run experiments based on the original dataset. This was RefSeer, and another dataset, ArchiveCS. ArchiveCS are all full texts of computer science publications from Archive. It's also free for research purposes, which we provided in 2018. Yeah, and finally, we study the results and we derive hopefully some recommendations how to develop and evaluate future local citation recommendation approaches. So let's see. Here in more detail again, the neural citation network architecture. It's a neural network architecture, as I said. We start with a citation context at the top left. Then we can derive embeddings of this citation context. This gets then feeded into a citation context encoder, which is a time delay neural network, TDNN, which consists of a convolutional layer, a pooling layer, and a fully connected layer. Also, the citing author information and the cited author information get now encoded in a citing author encoder and a cited author encoder. It's also a TDNN. And the outputs of these encoders get then concatenated into a vector S. And yeah, let's first go to the decoder. The decoder consists of an RNN, so a recurrent neural network with gated recurrent unit. The input are cited papers titles given as word embeddings. And the output is then the updated hidden state HI. And when you apply softmax, you get the probability for the cited document YI. Let's go to the attention. The attention, yeah, what's the idea of it? To emphasize the important encodings for the current time step. For example, you have as input the different encoder outputs, so for dingle words. The S, as you can see here again, this was the concatenation of the output of the citation context encoder, citing author encoder, and cited author encoder. Then we have the decoder output from the previous step H I minus 1. Then in the attention mechanism, we can first get the attention vectors A 1 until A 4. So we get the attention weights. This is the kind of weighting what is really important. So it's an attention score. And then finally, as usual for the attention layer, we get a context vector, which yeah has an internal weighting of the different features, you can say. Here's an example how this looks like. For example, if you have the citation context, neural networks are really cool, especially if they are convolutional by Chuck Norris and Bruce Lee as example. We can assume that these authors haven't written so many papers. And the target would be ImageNet classification with deep convolutional neural networks by some authors which are more well known. Then we can see if we visualize these attention weights that in this case you can see here the columns are first the contexts and then the citing author and then the cited author information. We can see that the focus, so the highlighting, is mainly on convolutional, a little bit neural and network and a little bit ImageNet. So it really is rather important to focus here more on the kind of signal words because Chuck Norris and Bruce Lee are not really indicative here. Yeah, we re-implemented this network from scratch and then we evaluated it. So we used RefSeer. This is a dataset which has already been used in the context of citation recommendation various times. We used the same setting as Ebitsu and Fang from 2017. However, we were not able to get the information about the cited authors for some unknown reason. Also, we used the same database. Anyway, we came up with 4.5 million context pairs. And then we split it up into 80% for training, 10% for validation, and 10% for testing. We also used another dataset, ArchiveCS, as I said. These are publications from Archive, the platform, and we focus on computer science publications. Yeah, we cut it out some citation context and citation length if they were too long. Anyway, we at the end had about 500,000 context pairs. And we had the same splitting, 80%, 10%, 10%. We also varied with different hyperparameters. Basically, we had an embedding size, number of filters, hidden layer size, batch size, vocabulary size, the filters in this TDNN, the time delay neural network, and the number of G or U layers. These are all hyperparameters which we varied. You need to know that Ibisu and Fang, so the original paper, had no different setups. They just used one setup, at least is what they published in the paper. So it might be interesting to see what is the effect of having different hyperparameter setups. And these are the evaluation results. What can you see? Well, the different rows are different settings. And then you can see you have the results for the two data sets, RefSeer and ArchiveCS. You can also see that evaluation metric, we used recall at 10. And then you can see also the number of parameters, which differs quite a lot. I want to present a few examples from this table. First of all, the first row, Ebisu and Fang, this is a setting which was initially used by the authors. We can see that in case of RefSeer, we get a recall at 10 of about 0.1. In the case of local citation recommendation, this is actually quite okay-ish. So you often get a value about 0.1 or 0.2 at most. We get a lower result as Ebisu and Fang, but this is because we do not have these cited author information probably. Interestingly, in the case of ArchiveCS, so here on the right-hand side, we get a recall at 10 of about 0.16. So it's higher than in case of RefSeer. There are probably two reasons for this. First of all, ArchiveCS is considerably smaller. So we only have 500,000 citation context pairs instead of 4.5 million. So it's very, or it's more likely that the paper which is a hit is more in this top 10. And secondly, ArchiveCS is also cleaner, so the full text do not contain so many weird characters and so on. Then what else can we see? The best result in case of ArchiveCS we get with these additional filters and a hidden size of 128 compared to the worst result in case of ArchiveCS, which is here the Ebisu and Fang, so the original setting, we have an improvement of about 10%. So here we can already say that, checking different settings might be worthwhile, also for the future. We can also say that if we increase the hidden size to 256, it does not lead to superior results. So in case of RefSeer, it's similar. In case of ArchiveCS, it's even worse. What else? If we increase the vocabulary size from 20k to 30k, in case of RefSeer, the results are quite similar. So we get here even the highest recall at 10 rate. In case of ArchiveCS, the results are quite similar, maybe a little bit better than usual. Then if we decrease the batch size from 64 to 32, we can see that the evaluation results decrease a little bit typically. Not that much, but at least a little bit. So it's good to have a high batch size such as 64. Yeah, that was more or less it. So let's come to the conclusions. In this presentation, we had a look on local citation recommendation, and we saw that ready-to-use implementations of local citation recommendation approaches are rather rare. So we vote for publishing implementations according to the FAIR principles. We re-implemented the neural citation network for local citation recommendation. This is available on GitHub. Feel free to use it. Then the evaluation showed that the results really depend on the used dataset. if it's large or small, for example, if it's clean or not clean, and so on. Then it differs from task setup to task setup, for example, if citing and cited author information is used or not, and in the different hyperparameters. So we could see that changing hyperparameters change the values up to 10%. Yeah, overall, the choices on the neural network architecture and the hyperparameters can have a considerable impact, which should not be neglected in our view. So in the future, you might want to consider different architectures and having a look also on which embedding size, hidden size, and so on makes sense. Yeah, these are the references, and now I'm open to the discussion. Thank you for your attention.